First of all, the work that I'm going to present you is the result of the collaboration between several current and former members of the Center of Cultural Informatics at the Foundation for Research and Technology in Greece. So the team consists of a data modeling engineer, Athina Kurtzotaki, a systems design engineer, Corinne Adair, three research and development engineers, Anastasia Xaridou, Kostas Petrakis, George Marintakis, two postdocs, George Brugiker, who is a former team member, and myself, and then the two heads of our lab, Jan Zizikas and Martin Dare. So let's start with the introduction. As you already know, a vast area of research in historical science concerns the study and analysis of archival sources, such as old books or newspapers, handwritten documents produced by public authorities, or even oral history sources. And by studying such historical sources, historians aim to describe, examine, and question a sequence of past events and find patterns of causes and effects. And the first common activity performed by historians in this context is the documentation, digitization, or transcription of the archival sources which are under study. Then sometimes there is the need of curating the documented or digitized data, especially in cases where the data comes from different and diverse sources. And this is very important for having more accurate analysis results in the next step. So finally, historians perform quantitative or qualitative analysis of the data, of course, depending on the kind of data and the type of the underlying research questions. So in general, it seems that there is a growing need for holistic data management approaches that can jointly support historians in all these activities. So we propose a workflow for holistic data management in historical archival research. So the focus is archival research. The workflow is provenance aware, which is something very important for long-term validity of the research results. It is also highly recursive, which means that historians can go back, make corrections or improvements, and continue their analysis. And it also it complies to established documentation and publication standards, with the aim to support data sustainability and semantic interoperability. And as we will see in the next slides, this workflow and the tools that we propose have been successfully applied in a large-scale European research project of maritime history. So now, what is the context of this work and the corresponding requirements and challenges? So the context is a European project called SILIT. It is a starting grant in the field of maritime history funded by the European Research Council. It's an ongoing project which will be running until January 2023. The principal investigator is Dr. Apostolos Delis, a historian from the Center of Maritime History of Forth. And the project also has partners in Spain, Italy, France, and Croatia. So the research focus from a historical aspect is the transition from sail to steam navigation and its effects on seafaring populations in the Mediterranean and the Black Sea. So historians study the effects of this technological innovation on the people and the maritime communities whose lives were drastically altered by the advent of steam. They also study the maritime labor market, the life on board and ashore, as well as the evolving relations among ship owners, captains, crew members, and of course the local societies. And the investigated maritime regions include coasts in Spain, ports in France and Italy, islands in Greece, and the ports in the Black Sea. While the period of interest is from 1850 to 1920. So the project manages list ship logbooks, payrolls, and registers of different types, such as sailor registers. And all sources are handwritten and cover multiple languages, in particular Italics, Spanish, English, French, Greek, and Russian. Also, they come from different issuing authorities, which means that sources of the same type but different issuing authority do not share the same format. And these characteristics make. So I turn off my video. As I said, all these sources come from different issuing authorities, which means that even sources of the same type but different issuing authority do not share the same format. And all these characteristics make data management more challenging. And here you see two examples, real examples of such archival documents. One corresponds to the Brig Eleni Koupa ship, and the other to a cargo steamer Leonidas from some Greek archival sources. So now, what are the data management requirements and the corresponding challenges? With respect to data digitization, there is a need for faithful transcription of the original sources, which means that historians want not only to document metadata information about the archival sources, but also information existing in the contents of the documents. As regards data consolidation, there is the need for curating and integrating the transcribed data. Historians need to be able to apply corrections, normalize values, or make enrichments. And a very important curation step here is the matching of different entity names that refer to the same real-world entity, what is called instance matching. For example, we want the matching of multiple location names that are actually the same location. And this is very important for enabling accurate statistical analysis, like finding the number of sellers per residence location in a certain time period. So this is why it is very, very important. And also something that is very important here is also the preservation of provenance information. So historians want to be able to find the provenance of any piece of information, such as its initial form before curation, the archival sources that contain it, and so on and so forth. And regarding data analysis and exploration, historians want to use the transcribed and curated data as primary sources for historical research. So this means that they want to be able to analyze statistically the data for drawing conclusions on possible impact factors, and also found answers to complex information needs. So let's now see the workflow and the tools that we consider for coping with these requirements. So here is a visualization of the considered workflow. The input is a collection of archival documents gathered from different organizations or authorities. These handwritten documents are transcribed using FASTCAT, and the transcripts are stored in a database. The next step is curation of the transcribed data, supported by the FASTCAT team environment. Then the transcribed and curated data are integrated and transformed to a rich semantic network. And of course, this requires modeling all data using an established ontology. In our case, we make use of the ISO standard CDOC CRM. And the semantic network is stored in a triple store, which is then explored through a dedicated data exploration system, as we will see. So this is an overview of the workflow. And now let's see the different tools. For data transcription, we have developed the FASTCAT system. FASTCAT is a web-based system that supports the collaborative transcription and curation of archival sources. So in FASTCAT, documents are transcribed as records belonging to specific tiplates. And a tiplate, which is configured in a pre-processing step and represents the structure of a single data source, allows organizing the data and metadata in tabular form, similar to spreadsheets. So then, for curating the transcribed data, we provide FASTCAT team, a special environment within FASTCAT that allows the curation of entities and vocabularies. So these two things. In particular, when data transcription is completed in FASTCAT and the historian selects to publish the record, all data of type, entity, or vocabulary term are copied to FASTCAT team. So in CILIT, for example, there are four types of entities that are of interest for the historians: legal entities, locations, persons, and ships. So here, the first automated instance matching process gives the same identity to instances based on some tiplate-specific rules. For example, the rule may say that for a given tiplate, if the first name, last name, and father's name are the same for two person instances, then these two instances must be merged and receive the same identity. Okay. And then for curating the entities and vocabularies, historians have different options, like collecting specific entity values, enriching the entities, performing manual instance matching, so select two or more entities and say that these are the same real-world entity, or setting preferred and broader terms regarding management of vocabularies, so creating an hierarchy of terms. And here are some user statistics, just to give you an idea on how historians use the system in the context of CILIT. So there are around 30 users from 5 countries. The number of configured tiplates is now 20, and historians have already created more than 600 records. And these are the numbers of vocabularies, person instances, location instances, ships, and legal entity instances. So you see quite a lot number of instances. So for integrating the data and creating the semantic network, we need to follow three main steps. First is to decide on the domain ontology to use for representing the data of the FASTCAT records and the curated entity vocabulary data. Second, we have to create the schema mappings that define how the FASTCAT data map to classes and properties on the domain ontology. And last, we need to run the transformations, considering, of course, the design, the schema mappings, and the domain ontology in order to generate RDF data, that is a semantic network. So as the domain ontology, we created a data model that is compatible to CTOC CRM. Here you see the main concepts of the model. So we have SIP, we have voyages, we have actors like sailors, captains, so on. We have also payments. Okay, good. So here is another example of how we model activities related to a ship. Okay, like we have ship construction, we have ship registration, ship ownership phase, we have a voyage, repairing of a ship, or the destruction of a ship. Okay, and of course, this is a very small part of the model, just to give you an idea on how we model information using CTOC CRM. So all new classes are, of course, subclasses of CTOC CRM classes, and the same for the properties. So then, after having defined the model, we have to define the schema mappings, and of course, along the transformations. And for this, we make use of the XML toolkit. And XML consists of an XML-based mapping definition language, also a user interface, 3M editor, which supports the creation of the mappings, and then the engine which executes the transformations. Okay, so using this toolkit, we transform all data in FastCat to a very rich semantic network. And this is just a very, very small example of the derived semantic network. So here we see that two ships, one with name Andrea and one with name Antonio, were constructing in the same place, Genoa. And imagine such a network with millions of vertices and edges. Okay, so the final network is really huge. And then this network is then explored using a research space. Okay. And the research space offers a semantic search interface where the user can formulate a complex query by just selecting entities and their relationships. For example, one can search for persons that were crew members at ships, and these ships are of type Brigadino. Okay, so the user using clicks can very easily express such an information need. And then we get the results in different forms, like tables, or even we can aggregate and visualize the results in different forms, using charts, for example. So here you see a grouping of all persons of this question based on the embarkation location. Okay, and we see that the majority of persons embarked at Genoa, for example. Okay. So research space offers this user interface. We will just need to configure all the fundamental, say, categories, like what you see here, person, place, voyage, and so on, and of course the relationships. And then we can run queries and get the results and visualize them. Okay, so to conclude, we have proposed a workflow for holistic data management in historical archival research. So transcription, curation, and then transformation to a semantic network and exploration. All this workflow is supported by tools like FastCat and FastCat Team. It is provenance aware, so the user can go back and see, can visit the original transcripts, okay, even through research space, so at any time, and get the context. And also, we follow the standards by using a model that is compatible with CTOC CRM and also RDF. And this workflow and the tools have been successfully applied in a large-scale history research project, SILIT. So some limitations and challenging issues. First, the configuration and update of the FastCat templates currently cannot be done by historians. So this is a process step, and this is a, we can say, a limitation that we want to fix. Then we have the instance matching process and the vocabulary curation in FastCat teams. This is a really very time consuming. We saw that we have more than 60,000 person instances. So although we have a first automated instance matching process, then this manual curation is really very, very time consuming for historians. And then we have the modeling and creation of mappings, which is difficult and time consuming task. Of course, it needs expertise in CTOC CRM. And the problem here is that the data sources are really very complex. So we have nested tables, have and the what is needed is an interaction between the data scientist and the historians in order to understand the data, okay, and then create the mappings. So our current and future work, we want to improve the configurability of the system, especially how the way we configure the FASCA templates. We want to fully automate this workflow. So the scenario here is that, okay, the historians explores the data through research base. So they detect an error, visit FASCA team, make a correction, publish the change, and then revisit the research base and continue their analysis. And of course, we want to semi-automate the ISAS matching process, the manual ISAS matching process, by adding human in the loop in order to learn to match instances. Thank you very much, and I'm happy to answer to any questions.